how would a Japanese company entering India in a big way? That too for a clean and green energy. We have Fuji Electric 2.0, which has just entered India with a big bang and acquiring a company, an Indian company called Consul Neowatt. And we have Mr. Sriram Ramakrishnan, the CEO of this company, to talk more about it. Sir, what does this acquisition mean and what does Fuji Electric 2.0 mean?
Sure, thanks. That's a great question. And, I was heading Consul Neowatt, and over the last 7 years, we built up Consul Neowatt as the fastest growing UPS company in India and became one of the largest Indian UPS companies. And Fuji Electric is a global power electronics company, and with a very large presence, globally in many countries, but their presence in India was not that strong. So they saw a great fit in acquiring Consul Neowatt to further their expansion plans in India. So on August 30th, 2019, Fuji Electric acquired Consul Neowatt. And the main objective was this gives Fuji Electric a great platform to expand their business in India. So there are a couple of aspects to this. One is, they are looking to bring in new products into India, like solar inverters, like more higher energy efficiency drives, where they want to leverage, Consul Neowatt sales and service network. So we can sell to more, they can reach out to more clients in India. And likewise, they are also looking to leverage the UPS product line of Consul Neowatt and how that can be exported to other countries in ASEAN region and Middle East, where, these products which are proven in India can be now leveraged and sold across Fuji Electric network. So I think it's going to be a great win-win. Personally, I'm very excited about this. I started my career at GE in the US as an R&D engineer and used to work with Fuji Electric semiconductors. And it has come a full circle right now where, now I've become part of Fuji Electric and with the mandate to grow Fuji Electric in India. So if you look at Fuji Electric 2.0, post the acquisition of Consul Neowatt, we have a growth plan for the next 5 years, starting from this year up to 23-24, where we want to become the leading UPS, variable frequency drive and instrumentation provider in India. And our objective is to grow the business from about 650 crores last year to about 1,500 crores in this time frame. And one of the objectives is not only use India for selling in India. If you see our tagline here, it is not only for India, but it is in India for India Plus. And when we talk about India Plus, we are talking about neighboring countries in South Asia, as well as in Middle East and Africa. So Fuji Electric wants to use India as the base to expand in these countries where Fuji Electric presence today is quite limited. So I think it's a great win-win for Fuji Electric and for Consul Neowatt.
And the Indian market is, I can't say it's difficult, but it's different.
Sure.
And especially it's a price-conscious market. And Fuji Electrical is known for its quality and also the pricing. And India is a very price-sensitive, as I said. So what are the plans, and any Indian-specific plans Fuji Electric 2.2 has?
See, if you look at one of the reasons for Fuji Electric to acquire Consul Neowatt was our R&D capability. We have built up a very strong R&D team in Pune, which is a DSIR approved R&D facility, and I would say one of India's leading power electronics R&D setup. So one of the objectives for Fuji Electric was how can we localize the Japanese technology which we have developed, Fuji Electric has developed in Japan. And how can we tailor that for Indian conditions, both for the performance of the product as well as to meet price challenges or the competitive market, which is India. So if you look at India, I think it is one of the few countries where you have players from around the world. So today in the industrial market, you have players from Japan, US, the Europe, and now China, and of course some Indian players. So it is definitely a very price competitive market. But you know, Japanese technology, definitely I think customers see value. And now if we can make it cost competitive and provide the local support, I think you know, we can have a really value proposition which customers will see big value in.
That was a good combination about the good technology, and also it's coming from Japan, and also price conscious India. I mean, if the products are good, obviously Fuji Electric 2.2 will be a big success. And thank you very much to speaking to SmartSustain. Thank you.
Thank you. Pleasure. Yeah. My pleasure. Thank you.